Now we're going to do a fun little demonstration for you here. And I have a volunteer who's going to come up and help me with this. And this is for you. I want you to be able to have a hands-on tool, because people tend to show me that I'm dehydrated. Prove to me I'm not dehydrated. I'm going to give you a little test that everybody in the room can use, and you're going to go home and play with it tonight and play with it with your friends. It's a test that comes from some of the acupressure and kinesiology that we learned. This is Gina, and Gina has traveled all day, and so she's been pretty dehydrated, so I thought she would be a good one to test, because she didn't get to drink her good water. So first of all, we're going to just test her, and I'm going to take you this way. Okay, and you can see it on the screen. I'm going to test the tip of her nose. If we're going to test her in the clear, I'm pushing pretty hard, and I don't get any muscle or energy break. And now we test the dehydration point, and I have no trouble breaking that because she's very dehydrated. So now we're going to try and find something. She goes to the store, she runs into the 7-Eleven, and she comes out with Smart Water. And she takes this, open it up, and let's take a swig. And you can actually take a swig of it, hold it in your mouth so it goes to the energy to the brain. Good. And unfortunately, you'll have to swallow it. No, not yet. Okay, now let's go back to our point. Did it hydrate? Not doing anything. The energy's not going anywhere. Okay, you swallow. You know what? I think I'll give you my glass so you can spit in it. I don't want you to have to drink all the soda. Well, the next ones, you won't want to drink these. All right, let's do some bottled water. So have a swig of RO. You can drink that, because it won't kill you. Hold it in your mouth. Now, is this going to hydrate her? It's even weaker. All right, you can swallow that. Now, sometimes we think, oh, we're thirsty, let's go for some juice. All right, so take a swig. You can swallow that, too. Hold it in your mouth. Good old pasteurized juice. Did it hydrate that brain? Not even. Yeah, that's right. And Sprite. Okay, now, you can swallow that if you want. You can spit it out, too. Okay, give me a swig, and you can put it on the table there. Okay, give me a strong, let's hear. Nothing. You want to spit it out? Swallow. You swallowed it. Okay. Now, this is good microclustered hexagonal ionized water. And let's put it in the mouth and see what we get there. Hold it in there. And is it going to hydrate or not? What's your vote? I can't even budge it. Now swallow. Thank you. You may have that.
May I have this?
You may. You're going to need 34 of them. You see, you could do that with your friends now. And you can show them. We gave her water. We gave her Smart Water. And it didn't do anything for her brain. We gave her juice. And it didn't do anything for her brain. And so we need to have the ability to take and show people. So now I've given you a little trick to test for dehydration. You first test them in the clear. And then you hold the point on the nose, and then you can give them tap water, you can give them RO water, whatever's available. And then you want to hold the last, and you can have them put it in their mouth, because it'll go to the brain, and it will show you if it's hydrating the brain. And isn't that amazing? What could we do to our society if we could change the hydration of our brains, starting from our schools, from kindergarten up? Yes, we could change our society, literally, if we would hydrate our brains.